I will be reading Psalm 25 today. To you, O God, I lift up my soul. In you I trust, O my God. Do not let me be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me. No one whose hope is in you will ever be put to shame, but they will be put to shame who are treacherous without excuse. Show me your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long. Remember, O Lord, your great mercy and love, for they are from the old. Remember not the sins of my youth and my rebellious ways. According to your love, remember me, for you are good, O Lord. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he instructs sinners in his ways. He guides the humble in what is right and teaches them his way. All the ways of the Lord are loving and faithful for those who keep the demands of his covenant. For the sake of your name, O Lord, forgive my iniquities, though it is great. Who then is the man that fears the Lord? He will instruct him in the ways chosen for him. He will spend his days in prosperity, and his descendants will inherit the land. The Lord confides in those who fear him. He makes his covenant known to them. My eyes are ever on the Lord, for only he will release my feet from the snare. Turn to me and be gracious to me, for I am lonely and afflicted. The troubles of my heart have multiplied. Free me from my anguish. Look upon my affliction and my distress, and take away all my sins. See how my enemies have increased and how fiercely they hate me. Guard my life and rescue me. Let me not be put to shame, for I take refuge in you. My integrity and uprightness protect me, because my hope is in you. Redeem Israel, O God, for all their troubles. The word of the Lord.
Well, last week we started talking about blessings and what blessings were. So, Lily, you weren't here last week, so we'll ask you your definition. What's a blessing?
Something that you are grateful for.
Okay, that's a good definition. Something that you're grateful for. Now, over their homework for the week was to speak to their family and to find out one blessing from each person. So tell us who told it to you, what, you know, whose blessing it was and what it was. Okay? Who wants to start?
Okay. So Nana's is the easiest. Me. I know that. And my mom's is having healthy kids.
Okay.
And my dad's is having me and the cats.
Oh. Ooh, okay. Who's next?
I'll go. Okay. My mom said that when she was little, her blessings were answered in God's time and not hers. Ooh. And then she also said me, because my dad wasn't home.
Yeah. What's yours?
Oh, mine. I said being able to show my acting, singing, and dancing skills year-round.
Okay. Caitlin, you didn't give us yours,
yeah,
did you?
I didn't. And I said being able to dance in the summer.
Okay. Guess you're up.
Well, I thought the assignment was blessings for that day, so that's what I wrote down.
That's okay.
My mom said we were blessed with beautiful weather for the open house. I went to a college visit. Just a little background for that one. Jason said a safe trip out and back to and from Indiana, PA, which was also for the visit. And Grammy said that I had a nice quiet day and I got all the work done that I needed to get done, and I saw a baby bunny in the backyard.
And what was yours?
I didn't know that I had to do one, but I'll just think. Well, like, for everything, like, not just that day. Like, that day was awesome, but, like, friends and family are cool.
Okay.
Cool.
Cool. I guess cool means it's a blessing. So. Even though most of the parents and grandparents said named you all as their blessing, anybody can relate to that? Is your family or your children a blessing?
Yes.
Anybody? Would you agree with that? That's a pretty big blessing for a lot of people, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
The weather?
Yes.
Safe travel?
Yes.
Yeah, it was already shared. Being able to use your talent. Now, I don't know who else out there sings and dances, or is it singing and dancing?
And acting.
Oh, acting and dancing. I'm not going to ask for any other volunteers, but anytime that we get to use the gifts that God has given us, that's a blessing, but it's what we call, I want to call a hidden blessing, because we're blessed, we can share it, right? But do you think there's more blessings there? What's the hidden blessing? What do you think? What's a hidden blessing?
I don't really know, but I'm like in the plays and stuff, so I'm bringing people joy.
Right, right. So if we use our gifts and we see them as a blessing, but we also are able to bless others, and that's a hidden blessing. So I brought my hidden blessing today.
Oh.
What is it?
It's a hammer with a bunch of screws in it.
It's not a bunch of screws.
She already knows what the hidden blessing is. This is my girly hammer, but it's kind of heavy. You want to feel it? It's pretty good, right? It's not going to break, and you can see on the end that, you know, I do use it, right? It's marked up. It's got some pits in it. But the hidden blessing, go ahead, Lily. Start it out. No, not that one. Do the big one first. Now, you always need a hammer, but
screwdriver.
Then you need a screwdriver, right? They're kind of life essentials. But besides that, keep going.
This one?
Nope. Yep. Oh, you're right, this one.
Oh, okay.
And then there's
another one.
That funky screwdriver. What's that called?
Phillips.
The star one is a Phillips?
Yes.
Okay, so then you have a Phillips. So then you get most of your needs met.
And another flathead screwdriver.
And then there's that tiny one.
For your eyeglasses.
Yeah, I don't think we're there yet.
But wait, there's more.
That one's the eyeglasses, right? So they're all hidden blessings. That's why the meaning of hidden blessing is that we don't see it all the time, right? But we know that there's more than just one thing. So when we share the blessings that God has given us, we bless other people. And sometimes if it's not a talent or something that we share like you do, Asia, that just by sharing how God has been good to us with other people, it's a word of encouragement for them. So it will bring them joy as well, especially if they're having a bad day. So now the blessings for this, your assignment for this week is to find hidden blessings. Okay? So you have to name the blessing and then tell me what the hidden blessing is in it. Okay? Now you have to use your brain. I know it's summer, but I know you can do it. Okay? Agreed? Okay, see you next week. Thanks. We continue this morning to listen as Jesus teaches his disciples and those gathered around him. But this time, instead of just talking to those, he uses a parable. Now let's open our hearts and let this parable teach us something this morning. You also recognize it if you listen to the words of our anthem this morning, that they also sang about it. So this is a double dose for you. So hear now God's word from the Gospel of Matthew chapter 13. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat by the lake. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat in it while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in parables, saying, a farmer went out to sow a seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on the rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly because the soil was shallow. But when the sun came up, the plants were scorched and they withered away because they had no root. Other seed fell among the thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. Still other seed fell on good soil, where it produced a crop 160 or 30 times what was sown. He who has ears, let him hear. The disciples came to him and asked, why do you speak to the people in parables? He replied, the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have even what he has will be taken from him. This is why I speak to them in parables. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand. In them is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah. You will be ever hearing, but never understanding. You will be ever seeing, but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become callous. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with their eyes, hear with their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them. But blessed are your eyes because they see, and your ears because they hear. For I tell you the truth, many prophets and righteous men longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches it away, what was sown in his heart. This is the seed sown along the path. The one who received the seed that fell on the rocky places is the man who hears the word, at once rejoices with joy. But since he has no root, he lasts only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, he quickly falls away. The one who received the seed that fell among the thorns is the man who hears the word, but the worries of this life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke it, making it unfruitful. But the one who received the seed that fell on the good soil is the man who hears the word and understands it. He produces a crop, yielding 160 or 30 times what was sown. May these words of Jesus continue to bless us this morning. Now, since New Jersey is technically the Garden State, I believe that most of us can understand the parable about sowing seeds. I know one of the things I love is the changing of seasons in New Jersey. And as spring and summer comes to fruition, to watch the local fields get prepared for planting. One day it's all plowed up, and then soon you see the planting being done, followed by a green that overtakes the field. Am I the only one that sees this?
No.
Okay. Now I know that according to where you live, you may see different kinds of crops that grow. But the one I pass every day on Yardville Hamilton Square Road is the corn crop. I watch as the corn appears, and then it seems to grow a foot every night. It goes from 1 foot to 2 feet to 4 feet, and then you begin to see ears of corn being formed on the stalks. And then we finally reach that season that everyone loves in New Jersey called Jersey corn season. You know that season, right? Everyone loves to stop at our local farm stands and enjoy not only corn, but all the local vegetables and fruits that are grown. And we all know that it takes careful planting to yield a good crop. Yet we can't explain how something like a huge stalk of corn with delicious corn on the cob, so sweet, how that really takes shape. Sometimes, even when we do the right thing in our gardens, we don't get the crop yield that we desire. And sometimes there are factors that we just can't control, which also have influence on the yield of our crop. Need I mention deer? Raccoons? Mm-hmm. Right? Squirrels? Those things have an impact on our crop. And for farmers who make a living out of their crops, having a bad season has a great financial impact as well. When Jesus was telling the parable, I could just see everyone nodding their heads. Yes, Jesus, that's right. If the soil hasn't been worked right, the seeds won't take root. Can you see them agreeing? Yeah, that's happened to me, Jesus. Or when he spoke of the weeds, we can all relate to the weeds. Many more nodded their heads. Oh, Jesus, you know all about the weeds in my garden, don't you? They're uncontrollable. Or the seeds that fell on the rock. Jesus, you have surely seen my field. I think I have more rocks than anything else. You see, Jesus tried to connect to the people by using parables that they could understand. We know that there always was a hidden meaning when parables are used. But you see, Jesus had to get their attention first. So when he talked about the seeds and the crops, he was getting close to their financial dependence as well. For those without faith, they would believe that this parable is nothing about good farming practices, when in fact Jesus says that there's so much more. There's a much bigger lesson to be learned. He goes on to explain that the soil represents four different kinds of people. The path, well, we can say the message just bounces off of them, for there's no understanding, and the seed just dies. The seed that falls upon the rock, some are lucky enough to take root. There is great joy, sometimes brand new in faith, but because there's not enough foundation or nutrition, they wither and die. Unfortunately, that happens too often today. The fire that is sparked burns out because there is no one near to continue to feed the fire. There is no more learning that takes place, or there is no connection to a faith community to support them. So that fire that starts dies out quickly. The seed that falls among the weeds is common. Oh my, it's common for us today. The seed grows, but because everything going on around us chokes us out, that nothing is produced that is worth anything. The crop is small and doesn't produce a good yield. We become overwhelmed by the world around us, and my friends, that's a slow, slow death. But the seed that falls on the fertile ground, now that's the seed that will produce the good things for the Lord. It's where the word is heard and understood. And the crop, even though the yield varies according to each person, is huge compared to the others. Something huge comes from something as small as a seed. But let's face it, we really aren't any Johnny apple seeds here that walk across the country sowing seeds of apples. As Christians, though, we are supposed to be planting seeds of his truth with our lives. Now, we already know that we're all gifted differently. So how do we plant the seeds of faith? Well, my friends, we do it all different ways. Whether it's cooking or sharing a meal, whether it's doing errands for a neighbor who needs a bit of help, whether it's praying for a concern that someone has shared, even though you don't know the person, you're sowing seeds of God's love. When we share something great that we read with someone who just happens to be in the same room, we're sharing our faith. We plant seeds of our faith in all kinds of ways, but we have to remember that we also need to provide nourishment. As the seedling begins to grow, And that too can take many forms. Sometimes it takes an encouraging word, or perhaps just a listening ear. Sometimes it takes finding out somebody's name, and the next time you run into them, addressing them by their name. Or maybe finding out something and asking them, how's your husband? How's your wife? How's your child? It shows that you are interested in them, that you care for them. Perhaps it's a friendly text or a phone call to let them know that you're thinking about them or praying for them. Now here's a warning, don't overdo it. Just like you cannot force anyone to love you, you cannot force anyone to love the Lord. Don't be a pest in your effort to share the Lord, or you will scare them away. Now, don't get creepy. You know what I mean. Or not only will that person begin to fear you, but they will turn away from the church and the community that you represent to them. You will not be able to reach everyone for Christ. But you will be able to reach someone if that is God's plan for your life. You may be able to reach someone that 12 other people could not even touch, simply because that person can relate to your story. And to that, we should all say, thank you, Jesus. Because Jesus has given us all a different journey. But with all of our journeys, we are told that we need to share that with someone else. My friend, we are all in this together. And it's not a competition. Let's do what God has commanded us to do. Let's share the things that God has laid on our lives. We can all do something huge for the Lord when we start with something small. Amen. As we leave this place today, let us remember that something huge can come from something small. Remember the blessings that God has given you and share them freely with all that you come in contact with. Go with His strength and His assurance that He will be with you and give you the words to say. Go in His peace. Amen.